पेंडेमिक कोविड 19 मार्क्स दिस इंडियन इकोनॉमी ऑन स्टैंड स्टिल बट इट्स फिजिकल डिविजन्स हैव बीन डिलीवरिंग दिस कंट्री विद अबंडेंस ऑफ रिसोर्सेज. सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस वन ऑफ द रिलीफ फीचर्स ऑफ दिस कंट्री. सो हियर बाय वार्मली वेलकम यू ऑल इन न्यू लर्निंग फेज ऑफ इंडिया आवर कंट्री एंड इट्स फॉर पॉलिटिकल एंड फिजिकल डिविजन्स. Let's discuss the country which has 8 union territories and 28 states with various relief features and abundance of resources. India, 28 states, 8 union territories, abundance of natural resources and their division. And this marks the physical features prominent for India. A land which has abundance of relief feature each have been associated with diversity of livelihood and living styles. Everything marks its presence and that presence generates from northern Himalayas. Tourism, tea cultivation, apple orchard, northern Himalayas, then later northern plains. And this marks the agriculture, tourism, service sector and industry sector. Now the peninsular India will be discussed today. Mountains, protection boundaries from the winds of the Serbia, then Thar Desert, Northern Plains, peninsular India, and then the coastal region. This we have to discuss in the chapter and that we are discussing one by one. So today we will discuss peninsular India. Have a look. Peninsular plateau marks its abundance of resources. One rough terrain marks most of Indian area and that being released at the south of the northern plains is the peninsular plateau. It is triangular in shape. The relief is highly uneven, but it is rich in resources, igneous and metamorphic rocks. It delivers various diversity and that marks us with the region, and this region is blessed with number of high ranges and valleys. The ranges are rich in resources and this marks the presence of tourism as livelihood, and even Betwa, Son, etc. rivers are also flowing. Tapi, Narmada even have the Arabali hills as the oldest range of the mountains of the world. Border it on the northwest side. Vindhyas and Satpuras are important ranges as well. So it marks the various features identity and that we will discuss one by one. Have a look on
the peninsular plateau is almost triangular in shape. It begins from the northern plains and extends till Kanyakumari, the southern tip of India. To the northwest of this plateau lie the Aravali Hills. The western Ghats and the eastern Ghats lie to the west and east of the peninsular plateau respectively. The peninsular plateau is divided into the central highlands and the Deccan plateau. The central highlands include the Malwa plateau and the Chota Nagpur plateau. They are bordered by the Aravali hills in the northwest and the Vindhya range in the south. Chambal, Son and Betwa rivers flow through the Malwa plateau along with their tributaries. They meet river Yamuna in the north. Along with these rivers, Narmada and Tapi also flow through the Malwa plateau. These two rivers drain into the Arabian Sea. The peninsular plateau receives rainfall from June to September and experiences a moderate to hot climate. To the east of the central highlands lies the Chota Nagpur plateau. Jharkhand, West Bengal, Bihar and Chhattisgarh, along with parts of Odisha, lie in this plateau. The Rajmahal Hills lie to the northeastern part of the plateau. Damodar, Son and Bokaro rivers flow through this plateau. It is rich in minerals. The climate of the region is hot and dry during summers. Winter and monsoon are pleasant. The Deccan Plateau extends from the Satpura range in the north to Kanyakumari in the south. The Sahyadri, Nilgiri, Annamalai and the Cardamom Hills lie to the western part of this plateau. Together, these hills form the Western Ghats. The highest peak of the Western Ghats is Annamudi, which is in Kerala. Some places of the Deccan Plateau experience semi-arid climate, while other places have warm climate. This plateau receives rainfall from June to October. Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri rivers flow through the Deccan Plateau. They flow from west to east and drain into the Bay of Bengal. Coorg, Kodaikanal, Idukki, Ooty and Wayanad are some of the famous hill stations in the Deccan Plateau. These hill stations attract many tourists. Chickpea, sugarcane, groundnut and millets are some crops that are grown in the plateau region. The eastern and the western Ghats have many forests which provide wood and medicines. Sambar deer, hyena, nilgai, sloth bear, Nilgiri thar and Indian giant squirrel are animals that are found in the peninsular plateau. Now we know that the peninsular plateau extends from the northern plains till Kanyakumari. It is rich in minerals, hence a lot of iron and steel industries are found in this region.
Bharat aur uski coastal line aur us coastal areas ke beech mein aapka peninsular plateau. This marks you with the Vindhyan range, Satpura range, Narmada, Tapi, Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, etc. for the abundance of water. The table land that founds and that delivers the soil fertility, even have richness of rocks and minerals. Abundance of resources, rocks and minerals, metamorphic and igneous rocks findings, and that delivers us the cultivation. Industry is very prominent in this region. This region marks the Maharashtra, Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, etc. in the formation. It gives the birth to the rivers like Narmada and Tapi. Even the west flowing rivers that drains in Arabian Sea. Even the east flowing rivers drains themselves in Bay of Bengal, as it discussed in the previous session. Western Ghats are bordered the plateau in the west and Eastern Ghat borders provide eastern boundaries. Ek aisi wasteland jo Western Ghat ki side se continuous hai aur Eastern Ghat ki side se broken hai. Minerals, coal, iron, rocks even provide industry and livelihood in this region. This region is most developed in India as compared to northern. To ye ek aisi jagah hai jo Bharat ke utthan ko Bharat उसकी एक दूसरे से जुड़ती हुई कड़ियाँ, कुछ ऐसा ही अस्तित्व है पेनिनसुलर प्लेट्यू का. इट कनेक्ट्स थ्री पॉइंट्स, छोटा नागपुर प्लेट्यू, मालवा प्लेट्यू, डेक्कन प्लेट्यू, मार्क्स वन रफ टेरेन दैट हैव बीन दी ब्लेस्ड विद अबंडेंस ऑफ रिसोर्सेज. बेटवा, सोन, नर्मदा, तापी, कावेरी, कृष्णा, गोदावरी finds its presence over here for the water resources. Ek aisi jagah jo industry ka prominent point hai, that is Peninsular Plateau, due to the richness in minerals, rocks, and that marks the resources presence, and then the industry is very prominent in this region. It delivers this backbone of India. It have been in the region of various states like Maharashtra, Karnataka, Odisha, Madhya Bharat, Madhya Pradesh, etc. So hereby we are concluding it for today by saying thank you for visiting.